Hello, my friends, and welcome back. Thank you very much for being with me again today. I will play a video here with a former State Department employee, official, so an American enforcer of, foreign policy for the country, United States of America. His name is Shelbovitz, and this Shelbovitz will attack verbally a vendor in the New York City streets. And he's going to use some racist language, Islamophobic language, and most importantly, threats. Threats, I will play the video, is about maybe a minute or so. And this guy got arrested. My point of making this video is not to show you that this guy's an asshole. My point is to show you that this guy worked for the US government and worked also, exactly so I can read it. He also worked for the U.S. Department's Office of Israel and Palestinian Affairs from 1999 to 2003. So for 4 years, he worked for Israel and Palestinian Affairs as a director, deputy director. And you're going to hear this guy calling this Egyptian immigrant in New York City. He's going to attack his faith. He's going to attack Muhammad. He's going to attack, not that you can't, I mean, free speech, but still, is you're going to hear how bad he's doing it. He's going to attack this guy's national origin. He's going to threaten him that he's going to contact his friends from immigration to call the secret police in Egypt to get his parents to pull their nails out, you know, and more than that. And takes a picture of the vendor to send it, he says, to the immigration friends so they can take care of him and deport him. So all these threats and all this garbage are in this video. My point is not that people like this exist. No problem noting that or noticing that. There's a lot, okay? My point is these people, maybe with a different allegiance, get jobs in the State Department and not only as advisors for the president with these kinds of views. Get more. I'm just kidding, obviously. So let me show you this little video coming from the Telegraph. This is what the guy says, among others. And I'm quoting, killing 4,000 Palestinian children wasn't enough. End quote. Ex-Obama advisor tells vendor in verbal attack. This is Stuart Shelbovitz. I looked for him to see his early life, but I can only guess something that maybe you understand what I'm trying to find out. His name and his location and his State Department, there's three big giveaways. Now, they say here, the former advisor to Barack Obama said that, and this is the video, and then, as I said, he was acting director for National Security Council South Asia, Asia Directorate under President Obama, a senior political officer, and was deputy director in the U.S. State Department's Office of Israel Palestinian Affairs from 1999-2003. Most recently, he served as Foreign Affairs Chair for Gotham Government Relations, which cut ties with him following the release of the videos, plural. Now, how did he get in that position? And we have what? We have Blinken, Anthony Blinken, and we have Victoria Nuland in the State Department. Right, and we have the Secretary of Yellen. Right, she is the Secretary of Treasury. Again, she deals with American money. So we have certain people, maybe with different allegiances, foreign entities' allegiances, that create the policy of the whole country and use the whole country's might, United States, for certain interests. Like, for instance, sending the U.S. Rapid response force in Eastern Mediterranean Sea. Two of them. Why is that? Or having destroyers in the Red Sea for whom? For American interests? Who sent them over there? Who makes the foreign policy of the US? Blinken? Who is Blinken? Who is Victoria Nuland? Who is Shelbovitz? Who is Yellen? Anyway, let me play this video for you. Alright, that's where I find the video is, where is it? Right here. Ready, set, and go. Warning contains video contains video, some my by booba.
You're a terrible person. You kill children, not me.
What?
Go.
My kids? What about my kids?
You kill children, not me. Go.
I didn't kill children.
Okay, what is he here?
You know what? If we kill 4,000 Palestinian kids, you know what? It wasn't enough. To my friends in immigration.
Really? Okay, go, yeah.
And to the Egyptian, the Muhabarat wants your picture.
Okay, yeah.
You know the Muhabarat?
Hmm?
The Muhabarat.
No, I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't speak English.
No?
He's going to take a picture for Muhabarat to send it to his friends from immigration to send it to Egypt to take care of his family. That's the threat right here. Jesus.
Yeah, go, yeah.
Muhabarat in Egypt will get your parents.
Go.
Does your father like his fingernails? They'll take them out one by one. That's a problem.
Mm-hmm.
Did you rape your daughter like Muhammad did?
Hmm?
Did you rape your daughter like Muhammad?
I speak English.
You only speak English?
No, speak English.
You don't speak English?
Yes.
Yeah. Right. That just shows how ignorant you are. Because, you know, Muhammad was a rapist.
Tell him, go.
Why should I go? Why should I go? Tell me why I should go. I'm standing here. I'm an American. I have free... It's a free country. It's not like Egypt. The Holy Quran. That some people use as a toilet. What do you think of that, people who use the Quran as a toilet?
I don't speak English.
You don't speak English? Yeah. That's why you're selling food in a food cart. Because you're ignorant. But you should learn English, and it'll help you.
Of course,
when they deport you back to Egypt, and the Muhabarat wants to interview you.
Obviously, this guy just wanted to hurt as much as he could. So we have Al Jazeera, where it says that ex-Obama advisor Stuart Selbowitz, arrested after Islamophobic rant. The former State Department official. So that's in the State Department is the foreign department, no foreign ministry, dealing with other countries in the name of this country, having this guy putting his thing over there. Was filmed harassing a Muslim street vendor in New York, saying more Palestinian children should be paparab buburu kaparab. So Stuart Selbowitz, 64, who previously served, we already got that one, was arrested on Wednesday on charges of aggravated harassment, hate crime stalking causing fear, and stalking at the place of employment, New York police said in a statement. Arrested. And this is what he said. First, let's see what the 24-year-old Egyptian vendor, American, whatever. A 24-year-old male victim stated to police that an individual approached him at his workplace multiple times and made anti-Islamic statements multiple times on different dates, causing the victim to feel afraid and annoyed, end quote, police said. The video went viral this month of multiple arguments over Israel's war on Gaza between Seldovitz and an Egyptian man working in a halal cart in Manhattan. And the vendor is seen telling Seldovitz to go, and I won't hear it. Seldovitz then responds, but you're a terrorist, you support terrorism, end quote. Now, a little thing more here. It says that Seldowitz also threatens to use his government connections to mobilize Egypt's secret police against the vendor. And here is the thing with the nails. Not appropriate. That's what he said, Selbowitz. This is what he said. I'm quoting Seldowitz. The comments that went beyond him, the vendor, and could be interpreted as attacks on Muslim and Arab Americans and so on, were probably not appropriate. End quote. Well, Not appropriate. Illegal or illegal? He told WNBC television, and I'm quoting again, the comments I made calling him out for his support of terrorism, those I think were appropriate, he said. End quote. So this is with Selbowitz, my friends. And my point here is not to show you this kind of people. They're all over. Don't worry. They just keep their mouth shut. Do you think that they are angels? No. They just trained. That's one thing. And my point is, this guy worked for the Secretary of State. And not only that guy. I remember, let me give you an example. As I said, there's three giveaways. I looked for Seldowitz in Wikipedia to see his early life. But as I said, three things. New York City, Seldowitz and working in the State Department, there's three giveaways for me as a previous intelligent guy. Not anymore, right? Yeah. So that's one. The other thing is, imagine that you would have me, a Romanian born, in the Secretary of State, State Department, dealing with the issue between the Hungarians and Romanians. Now, people familiar, my Hungarian friends and my Romanian friends, know exactly what I mean. Do you think that I, not gonna use United States of America a little bit for the Romanians against the Hungarians? Do you think I will be 100% objective? That's a possibility, not a big one, correct? We're human. Now, if you have an Hungarian instead of a Romanian, will use the United States might against the Romanians for the Hungarians? Most likely. And I will tell you a direct example. After the 1989 revolution in Romania, organized by foreign agencies, as Ceausescu warned us, but it was too late. He lied too many times, so nobody believed him. With the support of traitors inside Romania, this was the Romanian Revolution, on the foundation of the population dissatisfaction and hatred towards communism, Ceausescu, and not having food and water and other things. I lived through that. I can, how should I put it, vouch for that. After that revolution, the Romanian guys in charge, which were some traitors, why? Because they didn't tell us who did who and what and so on after the revolution. And not only, they were asking, they were bent over, pants down, waiting for Europe and United States of America to come and save Romania. Instead of saying, no, we're going to do it through our own force. We're going to be independent, a little bit poorer, but independent. Now you're a little bit better than poor, but you're a... That's what you are. All right? That's what it is. You can say, well, look what happened to Yugoslavia. Well, yes and no. You have a choice. You can't be both independent and strong and rich unless you are Israel. All right. So I'm not going to say United States of America because you know how things go. So anyway, after this, Romanians were waiting. The Americans wanted to make sure that the rights of the human rights and the minorities' rights were respected in Romania. Right? Right. Romania has a big minority, Hungarian minority, right? They have schools, they can speak their language, they have their culture and so on. Nevertheless, the Americans sent a senator that was the chief of a commission, of Human Rights Commission. And that guy, his name was, and I still remember him, was Senator Tom Lantos. Now, Tom Lantos, he was Hungarian. So they sent that guy to Romania to slap the Romanians around for the minority that he might have been a little bit subjective, you think. And that's exactly what he did. He behaved like a king, and these guys, not being tough and say, get the fuck out, you and your garbage, you know, get out, you know, and say, we're going to make it on our own. They were like, respect their rights. But these guys wanted more. That's why they came over. And this guy paid back those visas. And he insulted people like me, who at that time was just a little boy. But I still remember how I hated that guy coming and treating the nation of Romania, the Romanians, as garbage. And I was wondering, why are these guys taking it? Hey, the adults, why are you taking it? Why are you taking it? So I know how that was done to us then, by Tom Lantos, okay? And it was not his fault. The fault was of the Romanians, pieces of shit, who accepted to be humiliated by that guy who was representing the United States of America. So do you think that Mr. Seldowitz represented the United States of America when he dealt with Palestinians? When he dealt with Egyptians? With the Middle East? In a State Department? Do you think so? I have great, fantastic doubts. That's why I make this video. Just to warn you, my friends, you're gonna have people climbing and helping others climb with them in politics, in government, FBI, CIA, National Security, remember? NSA, You're going to have people like this in intelligence, in the military, in politics, in mass media, and they will have possibly different allegiances towards other entities. I will make another video after this with BBC. Go and check who's one of the directors of the BBC. I think her name is Danny Cohen. All right? And they got a letter. I will cover that in the next video. So watch that one. So my point is, be careful who you get, what kind of allegiances they have. Not this guy. This guy said something over there, ugly, threatened. Let the law take care of him. That's many like him around. Not only of his kind. Many others. Do you think that there are no Arabs thinking or saying the same thing among themselves regarding other groups and other countries? I guarantee you they are. Why? Because I know. I heard that. I heard other people talking about other people like that. I hope not, you know, not that these kind of people do not get the power and use the American wealth and might to settle scores outside between their little countries and their little locations with the US taxpayers' money and military and lives. And unfortunately, that's been kind of like happening in the past, 50 years at least? Stay strong, stay smart, look for the truth, and be just.